Jain friends, this is Ram Sudhir. I am here to announce our new course, that is the GS Foundation course for the UPSC Civil Services. That is the prelims cum mains batch, which is going to start from September 1st. Why a formal announcement? Formal announcement because I want to make few things clear, in the sense that what are we going to do in the GS Foundation and how are we different in terms of our coaching. So these are the few aspects which I wanted to stress in this video. And I also want to give a message to parents as well as students. When we are acing for such a competitive exam, how should our mindset be? Are we really prepared for taking this exam called UPSC? Is our mind ready? Or is it something we have to do before coming to the coaching institute itself? So these are the points which I will try to explain here. The most important area which I will try to address is a kind of an advice or a suggestion, I can say, which parents as well as students will definitely benefit if they follow these tips. Okay. Now, what I personally believe, and there was a lot of research also that was done, that everybody's individual IQ is going to be different. Everybody's aptitude for subject is different. Their approach and concentration levels are different. Now, what we believe at our institute is, when you are coming to us, we take you as an individual student, or in fact a kid coming to our school. So this is what our approach would be. A separate file will be maintained for each and every student, where we are going to personally monitor. Our group of 15 teachers, and we have more than 10 mentors. And in these mentors, we have people in service, IAS and IPS officers. We have Rakesh Chintigumpala, and we also have Murthy BBGTS IPS. Okay, and we have several rankers like Swaroop, who has got 98th rank this time. And we have Surya Teja, who has achieved 75. We have Naveen. So they are also going to be part of our program, especially with respect to mentoring you and trying to address your problems. Now, when you're coming to the institute, we take it that you do not know even ABCD of UPSC. You need not know any basics of NCERT. At Ram Sudhir's case, in our Swayam Siksha, we are going to teach the subject from very, very basic. Somebody from engineering background, or you are from arts background, or you are from any background, you will be taught everything from basics. The first 10 to 15 hours, yes, we are going to spend on teaching you basics of every subject. This is one important aspect. Why is it so important that you have to teach a student basics? Is many a times, after 50% of the syllabus is completed, many students feel that since they are from a different background, they are not able to follow polity or maybe economics or maybe some other subject. The problem here is, you would have studied even difficult subjects like thermodynamics, etc. in your engineering. That means you are capable of definitely understanding these subjects which are going around us. The only thing is, you have to be given that right guidance. You have to be nurtured from the basics. Once you know ABCD of the subject, then any depth can be explored. This is one thing. The second important aspect which we do here is, each and every student will be assigned a mentor. So this mentor is somebody who has gone to interview, or has written mains exam, and our rankers who are already in service, they will try to address your problems and doubts on a weekly basis. That means after 6 to 7 days of classes, the student has to sit with the mentor. Because it is COVID period, the student can at least come for a Zoom call with the mentor, and you will be trying to put forth your problems with respect to subject, with respect to your receptivity with respect to subject. Whether you are taking tests, we are going to be a little strict with respect to take test taking, because every week when you can take tests, okay, especially when you're solving MCQs and when you're writing answers, at least one answer, two answers initially, every week, and you'll be closely monitored and nice feedback will be given by the rankers, then automatically you will be growing, or in the sense like your capabilities will increase and you will not find it difficult at the end. This is one more thing which we do. And since we are maintaining a file, a record of your performance, every week on week we will try to see the way you are progressing, which is very, very important. Now, one more important aspect which I wanted to make it clear is, many students take 3 to 4 years or 5 years to clear the exam. One important problem is they search for a golden rule. Now, what is this golden rule? Golden rule means, oh, this ranker has followed this path. He has read this book, Lakshmikant, and he has solved some questions, and this is how he did, and therefore he is in service. One more person has attempted 95 questions, 98 questions. One person says, I've studied 18 hours, you know, 19 hours every day, and therefore I've cleared the exam. Somebody says, no, no, we have studied only for 3 hours, you know, I was also working and still I have cleared the exam. Now, these are the things. Is it wrong? No. It is right according to them. Definitely it is right because it worked for them. When it works for you, you feel, yes, this is the strategy. But to be very open, in UPSC, especially civil services, the strategy should be different for different students. It cannot be a uniform strategy for everybody. This is what something like a parent has to understand, a student also has to understand. Especially parents, when they say, come on, read for 6 months and crack civil services. Now, is it that some students have cracked it in the first attempt? Definitely yes. But there should be a very proper planned approach. We cannot pressurize the student. Come on, you start studying and don't move out of the room for next 1 year and you are going to be successful. You are going to be an IAS officer. So this kind of pressure, if the parent or the teacher puts, that will not work. Yes, you should study for a long period. At the same time, you should be doing smart work, a planned approach, a step-by-step approach. That is what is very, very important, especially for this exam. So once our basics are strong, every week you are monitored one-on-one by the mentor and you are writing consistent tests. And once the foundation is strong, this is the GSR prelims cum mains batch, it's a foundation course. Once the foundation is strong, then definitely I can tell you, cracking the exam in the first attempt should not be difficult. It is a doable target. Okay. Now, sir, how are we going to design a strategy? Now, based on your weekly performance, we will decide a plan. We are going to come up with a strategy. And that strategy which we are going to come up with will be unique to you. It should be for you. That strategy is for you. That strategy is not applicable for everybody. So such a kind of strategy we have to prepare for each student. And only then it is possible that you can clear the exam in the first attempt. So be prepared. Be prepared. So this is something which is written there. Be prepared in the sense that be prepared with respect to spending number of hours with respect to preparation. Two, be prepared with respect to having a proper balance of mind and coming up with a strategy which is going to be quite different in the sense that you have your strategy. This is the way you are going to prepare based on your aptitude, based on your memory, and based on your success which you have seen from your childhood. All the three have to be taken into consideration before coming up with a strategy for a student. So this is what we do at our academy. It's not just about a teaching class where teachers just teach and deliver lecture and they move out. So this is something like a planned approach which you have to come up with here. Okay. And one more important aspect which I wanted to mention here is the way you plan and which is the best time to prepare. So which is the best time to plan for preparing? See, simple logic is, the best time to prepare for UPSC is during your graduation. Then, sir, is it that we have to join BA, Bachelor of Arts, or something that is only there in civils in our degree classes so that we clear UPSC in the first attempt. No, it is a myth basically. If you take the statistics of people who are clearing the exam, you find engineers and doctors are more in number or clearing. So this clearly shows that you need not select a degree so that you ace UPSC. You can be from any degree based on your liking, based on your choice, but simultaneously you can prepare from your place. There is a lot of availability today of material. You can listen to our classes online, especially degree students. If you can spend 1 or 2 hours in the live session with our teacher and you can plan your preparation very properly along with your regular engineering or medicine or some course of your choice. You can take any course of your choice. You need not change your course for civil services. You can take a course of your liking and still prepare for UPSC. So this is something which is a very keen aspect because many parents feel that we have to join the student maybe in his degree he should be doing public administration. Let him study history. Because if he studies engineering, we are wasting time. No, that's not the case. You can study engineering as well as you can also go ahead with your preparation for civil services. And if you are starting early in a planned manner, definitely it will help you. Then somebody who is 26, 27 years of age, he may feel, sir, then what? The average age, if you see, with respect to a person in training is around 27 to 28. That means most of the time, that means the number of attempts are high. But always it is better if you clear the exam at a younger age. But at the same time, this exam demands maturity. Now, another important aspect is maturity. Now, why are you, sir, what is this maturity? A balanced mind which can focus on studies without getting into diversions. That is what is maturity. So it is about delayed gratification. I believe that I have to focus on something for the next 6 months or next 1 year. The biggest challenge is if you are really giving your time for that particular goal which you have fixed, then definitely we can achieve the target in the first attempt. So without sacrificing on your degree, you can take the degree of your choice. Simultaneously, you can join us and be personally guided by our mentors and rankers and listening to our classes for around 2.5 hours to maybe 3 hours every day or at least 2.5 hours. You can plan your preparation from degree itself, from your engineering itself. Okay. And those who have passed out their engineering, you can spend complete time with us. You can write answers. You can interact with teachers. And definitely, you can clear the exam in the first attempt. So, this is something which is the most important aspect. So, you should have a clear-cut timetable. You should have a clear-cut timetable like how to prepare for UPSC. So, preparing for UPSC, there should be a clear-cut timetable. That means, how do you prioritize your syllabus? How do you, read newspaper? Okay. How do you make notes from day one onwards? How are you going to write tests every week and get it evaluated by the teachers and mentors? And including your physical and mental health has to be planned from day health. This is an exam of planning because it puts you under a certain amount of pressure and that pressure can be handled only by a planned person or a planned student who is going to plan his preparation. Very, very important. So, another most important aspect is the way you plan. You can see there. Okay, so we have put in there a timetable where we have also included something like physical exercise in the sense that you have to stay active all throughout the day. Okay, and therefore, having utmost concentration with respect to preparation and handling stress for 1.5 years is not a joke. And therefore, there should be a proper plan. A planned person, stress will be less. At the end, you can fight out your battle well. So, champions are basically, they are just recognized in the ring. You become a champion already when you are in the practice. So, you practice so well every day and every week that in the ring, you are not going to fail. Now, if you do this, I can assure you that definitely the goal of UPSC is there. So, we are waiting for you all. So, our admissions are in progress. And we can say we are very much efficient in the sense that the pricing also, we have kept it very low because of COVID. And we are also going to come up with the personal mentorship and tests. Everything is included in our program. And along with that, you can have direct interaction with our rankers who have cleared the exam since last 7 years. A personal interaction to keep your motivation levels high. So expecting you and waiting for you all to take a decision. And we are definitely there to make your dreams come true. And all the best. Thank you. Thanks a lot.